So you and I both know how important typography is when it comes to graphic design. So it kind of makes sense that we organize our font collection. Now, I did dabble in using font managers quite a long time ago, but that was a long time ago now, quite a few years. But recently, the people over at FontBase reached out to me to have a look and preview their font manager app. And so that's exactly what I've done in today's video. And what I found is pretty interesting, and I think it will appeal to those out there who really are serious about the typography and the fonts. FontBase is jam-packed full of features, and some have really surprised me since the previous upgrades. But first, one of the most crucial things about any font manager, in my opinion, is the user interface, and FontBase seems to be pretty neat and pretty intuitive too. So on the left, we have our fonts and our folders, and then of course, the placeholder text, which you can edit. There's also a size adjustment slider, an option to see a grid or a list layout, and I personally prefer the list layout, which is the preset standard. And then also you can change up the colors of the font displays and also the background. So it might be something like it's late at night, you've been working all day, and the white background is too intense for your eyes. And it's just really easy to change that here. Now again, everything is pretty straightforward and pretty intuitive as well. But moving on to one of my favorite features, the Super Search feature, which can be found here under the lightning bolt. Now this essentially gives you four categories to refine your search in real time. And so FontBase has worked out my font collection according to these four categories. I can select a portion of my font library according to the contrast of the font, the weight, the proportion, and also the X height. So as you can see here, I've narrowed down my library to the most weighted fonts that exist. But then of course I can flip it over and select some of the smallest weighted fonts that I have. I can then go on to couple that with, say, a large X height. So yeah, this Super Search feature is, well, pretty super. And it's one of the more recent updates to FontBase. And yes, I know, the placeholder text has a typo, but let's ignore that for a second and concentrate on something that will save you heaps of time and possible headaches. The fact that FontBase has a feature that auto-activates missing fonts when opening Adobe documents. So now all of the missing fonts in your Photoshop, Illustrator, and InDesign documents will be automatically activated, and so it's probably a clever idea just to keep this thing switched on permanently. Something else I found pretty neat and a nice little time saver is the fact that FontBase allows you to come into any font and then copy a glyph simply by clicking onto it. So you can grab any GIF you want from here just by clicking it, and then you can move into something like Adobe software where you can just paste it on like so. But also you could slap a glyph anywhere else pretty much, so maybe a DM in Twitter, or just wherever you want to use it. It's a nice little time-saving feature, I feel. But here's something that helps when you're trying to find the right font for a specific design. Let's say I'm looking for a light-weighted font, and I can obviously use the Super Search option, and I like the look of this font here, B Vietnam. Now if I click the pin option, that font is going to remain at the very top. So as I scroll through my library, I can compare other fonts to that one. This of course also helps if you're trying to look for a good font pair, as you have the first one at the top and you can just check to see what pairs up with it nicely. But next to the pin icon is a heart icon that adds your fonts to a favorites list that's located off to the left. Now I do remember showing B Vietnam font family in an old video, and it is really a good family, but we can come into it here and check out all of the fonts that make it the font family, including the glyphs and seeing the typeface in a waterfall presentation. One handy feature is the watch folders. So typically, when you drag or add fonts to FontBase, they are copied to the FontBase root folder. But not everyone wants to keep their fonts there, so instead, watch folders have been created. So when you add a watch folder to FontBase, a link to it is created in the FontBase root. They're not copied, they're just linked there. So this means you can have multiple people accessing the same fonts. But also you can do things like add your browser downloads to a watch folder, so the fonts are automatically indexed onto FontBase immediately. With FontBase, you need to click the white circle next to a folder or font to activate them. However, you can right-click a folder and enable the auto-activate function. So now any font added into this folder is automatically going to be activated. And that just means you won't have to manually go through and, you know, activate every single font that you want to use. You might also be curious to know how your font works well together on something like, say, a web page. Well, if you come into this section here, you can play around with your font library in real time, mocking things up on a web page. We can make headings, subheadings, and body text, perfectly allowing us to see what fonts work best in what situation and paired up with what. So yeah, I really enjoyed having a look around FontBase and the upgrades, and as well as, you know, how it can streamline my font use in graphic design. Now, FontBase is pretty affordable at $3 a month or $29 annually, or you can, of course, just spend $180 for a lifetime subscription. But today, FontBase are offering you guys 3 months totally for free when you sign up to a monthly subscription to the app. And that is when you use the code Satori, all in uppercase lettering. Now, I never post anything on this channel unless it's something I wholeheartedly believe in and think that you guys will find useful. So you can find FontBase linked down in the description box below. Some days ago, I asked you guys to redesign this Nike advert in one of my before and after style videos. There were so many design entries sent to me, but I've selected three that were pretty decent and I thought worked pretty well. That's not to say if you don't see your design, yours wasn't good. But the first design was made by Sahib, which I thought made good use of linking colors throughout his design, and also great use of hierarchy too. Sahib increased the leading on the body text below the trainer, which I do agree with. The next design was by Frank, which I like a lot in terms of color and also layout. However, the leading on the body text is too closely packed together in my opinion, but overall it is a good design. And lastly, Hamza has made very original content here, where the dividing green line flows through the design in the direction of the Nike swoosh on the trainer itself. Now, this is a very clever design and it's really, really neat. And you can find links to the portfolios of these three designers down in the description box below. There is another competition running that you can find on my community page on my channel homepage, and the winners will be announced next week for that competition. And until next time, design your future today. Peace.